sideline yelling, "Go! Go! Run! Touchdown! Yeah!" I know I have, because that's my mom. My mom believed in me when I didn't believe in myself. She gave me the gift of self-confidence and self-love. Unfortunately, a lot of kids aren't as fortunate. Have you heard of Gabriel Reynolds? Gabriel was an 8-year-old third grader in Cincinnati, Ohio, at Carson Elementary School, who went into his room one day at school. And after a short period of time has passed, his mom went to go check on him. And when she opened the door, she had found her 8-year-old little boy had hung himself. Because of bullying. Kids are committing suicide because they feel like no one to talk to. They feel alone. And some kids want to end the pain and the suffering. Bullying is personal to me. Real personal. Why? Ever since I was 5 years old, I had a dream of being the number one running back. But that dream soon turned into my worst nightmare when I was getting bullied on the football field by my teammates. The bullying escalated to a level I could no longer face. It was a tidal wave of panic and a horrible feeling no one should have to endure. If you don't know what bullying feels like, here's one word to describe it. Painful. The Center of Disease Control states that at least 30% of kids admit to bullying others. Guys, we have to stop the bullying. There have been too many kids who have took their lives because of bullying. I, the truth, would like you to talk to every kid you know today about bullying. Not tomorrow, not next week, today. Now, let me ask you a question. Are you part of the problem or are you part of the solution? I'm Christian and that's the truth. I'm walking in it.